All right, guys. So now last time we went ahead and added these fancy filters we have on the screen right here. And I came with a promise to tell you that we are going to be exploring adding some more advanced types of filters. Now, the brand filter here with the images is kind of already kind of pretty fancy, if I don't say so myself, but we can still add things like conditional logic in there. And then I also wanted to step through adding select two filters right here on the page. And if you don't know what those are, let me show you. Okay, so here we are on the select two page. What are select two filters? Well, they're just the easier way of navigating large quantities of data that you've got in select dropdown boxes. This is your typical dropdown box, and it is a lot to go through. So what if I could just go in and type in, let's say, California, and then you can add or find the option that you're looking for. It's a really easy and simple way to display things a little bit better, but it goes even further. You can go and have, you know, multiple options in here. So then I can go Illinois, for example, and then I'll have Illinois also in there. And you can also easily remove them. It's just a really great way to show these on your site. And then, of course, a better user experience. And I'm a big fan of these select boxes using the select two. Okay. And then what we are also going to be taking a look at is, of course, conditional filtering. So what does that mean? Well, when we can apply conditional logic to maybe sequentially show fields as you're, you know, populating these. Maybe you only want to have colors or stock show once you've selected one of the other options. So I'm going to show you how to do that. And then maybe we'll even take a look at some empty filter options as far as, you know, what is still displayed as options here. Stock status could be a good one to look at, as well as, you know, different colors and things like that. We did touch on that on the previous videos, so I'm not going to get into that too deep. You know, empty filter options is a very, very deep rabbit hole you can go down. And I definitely suggest you take a look at the documentation that we've done where we cover different ways to utilize this. So I will link that also in the description of this video. So don't you fret, but for now, why don't we go and get into it? Okay, so the way we usually get started here is by going to our page that we've been editing, and we will go and enable the visual builder, and we'll wait for Divi to do its thing and dump us right into the visual builder. All right, so we are all loaded up. And again, the tricky thing is with everything not being visual builder compatible at this time, as we're kind of like bracing for Divi 5 and rewriting all of our plugins with full visual builder compatibility is, you know, you don't see the results of your labors immediately. That can be a little bit frustrating. We get that. It's just counterproductive for us to invest a bunch of resources now on developing that and then having to change it all and recode it in a month's time or 2 months' time. Who knows when Elegant Themes will kind of let that loose on the world. We hope sooner than later so that we can get our teeth sunken in and get you ready for all of this. Cool, that's words. Okay, so I'm gonna give us a quick example of how we can utilize conditional logic within our Ajax filters. Now, you would use this method with pretty much any of our filter plugins. So Divi Machine's got Ajax filters in it, Ajax filter plugins got it in it, and BodyCommerce has got it in it. So if you have any of our other plugins that utilize that, you can go ahead and use this methodology as it will pretty much look the exact same. So first, I'm just going to give us a very simple example here and just show the stock status as long as any of these fields have a value. So I'm going to go into the stock status settings. And then, of course, we've got conditional logic down here. Now, here I need to point out a few things that are very important. You've got a few elements here. You've got logic ID, logic title, and then whether it's enabled. The logic ID is very important here because this is what we're comparing. And then the logic title is kind of like what it shows up as when we enable this here, which you'll see. And then, you know, you can go ahead and you can select your rules. But of course, this is the only one that is active right now. So the first thing we're going to do is give all of these a good logic ID so they're easy to kind of work with. Okay, so let me just get out of this one really quick. We'll go back in to our settings. So first one, search. We go down to conditional logic. Now, you don't need to activate this. Very important, because otherwise you're comparing a bunch of logic or looking for a bunch of logic, which can be a pain later on. I'm just going to put your F for filter underscore search. So something that's kind of descriptive so I can remember these when I'm looking at other things. And then, of course, we can just say search filter here, for example. I'm going to save that one. And then we'll go to the next one and we'll say categories. And we'll go down to conditional logic. and we'll again go F underscore categories, and then we'll say category filter. And let me just keep that capitalization accurate. And there we go. And we're going to fly through, and I think you can guess what we're going to be doing here. Oops, clicked the wrong thing. We're going to stick to this naming convention. We're going to go F underscore price, and then we'll say price filter. Go ahead, and next is brand, conditional logic, F underscore brand, and then we'll say brand filter. And you can kind of get the vibe here of what I'm up to. I am just making sure that everything is nice and consistent so that I can easily reference any of these. And this one was color, F color, filter color, and then we'll just say color filter. Okay, cool. Now we can go back down here, and it can be a little bit wonky sometimes. You need to maybe just save this, be sure that those filter field names have been committed and those IDs. And I'm also going to go the extra step of refreshing my page. Now, you shouldn't have to do this every time. Let's go back into our filter settings here and just make sure that all this is taken and we've got everything in here correctly. So that has saved in here. But now we're going to enable on our stock filter this setting. And when you click the drop down here, now you've got a whole bunch of options as far as what does this rule need to pertain to. So we want this to show up just as soon as a selection has been made on the page. So for search filter, we will say equals search filter, and we will just say that is not empty, okay? Very easy. Now we're gonna use a different scenario in a little bit and I'll show you that, but that's what we're gonna do right now. And for right now, when you click on the relation here, you can say choose whether any or all the rules should be fulfilled. So when I flip this over, it says, okay, well, all the rules need to be fulfilled or any. We're gonna go with any because if any of these is true, so if any selection has been made here, the stock filter should show. So let's just go in and do the exact same for category is not empty. And then we'll go to price and we'll go say is not empty. And then we'll go to the brand and we will say is not empty. And then as you guessed it, we're going to go for color and we're going to say is not empty. Now, before I go ahead and save this, I just want to go through what these different things mean. You can say, for example, if category equals one of your categories, the slug that for that category, then that thing should be displayed if that value is true. Now, if you say it's greater than, you might think about a price. So if the price is over a certain amount, you might want to add a filter for a salesperson to contact them. I don't know. There could be various different things that you could look at in that way. Then you can say contains. So does it have whatever text or category is contained within the products? By saying does not contain. And then also you can just, if it's empty, then it shows. We're going to stick to this. So let's go ahead and save our filters here. I'm going to save the page. And then once that's done, we'll check out the front end of our site. Okay. So in stock status and all that fun stuff is showing. Why is that? Because it is quite likely that it is reading this price here as being filled out as it starts at 7, goes up to 45 right off the bat. So these are the type of things that you're going to need to account for. So I can go ahead, enable the visual builder. Yeah, let's go back here. That's not what I wanted to do. Enable the visual builder. Filter. That's not a word. Builder. Okay, so let's just edit this again. And then I'm just going to come here where I am selecting what it is filtering to be. I'm going to delete that price filter because it's not relevant. And if I am going to be guessing here, and if I was a betting man, I'd say that probably the brand and the color filter might do the same. But this is trial and error, baby. Let me see. I'll make the mistake so that you don't have to. Okay, that's all saved up. Let's go to the front end. Okay, so now that has worked. We don't see any stock status, but I click on a color, boom, it appears. Now, if I reset the filter, again, it goes away. And this time, let's select a category, men, and then the stock status comes up again. Isn't that cool, man? It's a really cool way to kind of make your filters a little bit more dynamic. Maybe you've got, let's say, a website that's got a bunch of wine on it, right? So you're going to have, is that right? A red or white? So maybe that's the first thing you want people to select. And then the next thing might be, well, what varietal do you want? And then from there, what vintage and all that fun stuff. Like you have these filters display as the people are filling out that specific value. It's a very good way to just create that extra interactivity. And if you really want to narrow people down in certain columns so that they don't get like choice overload and end up not getting too deep into your site and end up not converting. So that is conditional logic on just that one field. Now I'm going to look at another one where we're comparing an actual category, let's say, and we'll just have it, I don't know, show brand based on the categories. How about that? So we're going to go ahead and enable the visual builder yet again and just wait for it to finish loading. I'm going to open up our filters here. And now we're going to say, well, we only want to let people see the brands when the category of men is selected. So we're going to go into the brands. We're going to go here to conditional logic. And I'm going to say, okay, well, we're going to enable it. And now we go. If the category equals men. Now, remember, this needs to be the slug. Of that category. Otherwise, it will not work. It's case sensitive. A lot of things with this one. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. And let's see what that does on the front end real quick. Okay, all saved up. Let's exit. And now you can see here the brands is not visible. That's what we want. Now, if I go accessories, stock status shows up, but wait a minute, brands still aren't there. But if I select men on the other hand, boom, we get brand in there. Very cool way, again, just to demonstrate how you can use this conditional logic in different ways to achieve different results. Now, I want to mention one more thing on conditional logic, and I'll jump into the visual builder here. And it is to have just a more restrictive condition. So basically what I mean by that is I'll just use the brands example again. So scrolling down here to conditional logic, we already have our old rule in here, but what I want to point out here is the relation. Now what this refers to is basically you can have it have only require to have one of these rules to be true or that all of them need to be true. Now this is very useful when there are two particular conditions that need to be met for a certain field to be shown. It could be a VIP exclusive or whatever the case might be. You can decide that. It could be in relation to pricing. If something is over a certain price in a certain category, you want them to be able to filter out or only show other results. And this could be real estate agents or whatever the case might be, who a certain property needs to go to. I don't know. That's going to be for you to decide and your clients to tell you. But I just wanted to make sure that you're aware. So if you wanted to have the requirement for all fields, you just switch it to all. Simple as that. So if you have multiple rules down here, it will mean that all of these need to be true for this filter field to show. And if you say any, it would be if any one of these conditions that you set here ends up being true, then, well, it's going to show that field. So I wanted to make sure that you're aware of that before we continue on and start talking about select two fields and how you can utilize that in your Divi Ajax filter in BodyCommerce. So let's take a look. So for this, let's just quickly take a look at our one select field here on the screen, which is our categories. And we have got that pretty vanilla select options going on. So let's go ahead and enhance that with select two. And it's super easy to do. Just enable the visual builder again on the page where you would like that. You need to make sure that you've either got a select two field or a checkbox field or something where there are multiple options. Now, this doesn't work great for all scenarios, mostly for larger data sets. If you think about Amazon product categories, that would be a good one because it's got such a wide range of categories there. But for our case, we're just going to demo this out so that you can see how it works. And we're going to go and work on our categories. Now, categories, we come and we scroll down and there's all these different options, but you want to make sure that you've got the filter type of select. And then when we come down to select, you just enable select two options. Then you can have a little bit of extra first category option if you want to go ahead and change that and all that fun stuff. In design, you'll have additional styling options, but that's what you do here. Now, there's another place we need to enable this. So when you come down here on the main options for the actual filter module, you want to make sure to also enable select two. If you don't do that, it is not going to work. So let's save that up. Let's save the page and let's check out the front end and see what's going on. Now, on visual inspection, this all looks pretty vanilla. But when you click down, now you've got this awesome drop-down box that you can type in and you can just go ahead and narrow down all the options within your select drop-down. Now, if this was a checkbox field, for example, guess what? Now you would be able to select multiple, for example. So just a really great way and such a simple way to enhance your site with whittling down large options of data that you need users to access quickly. Nobody wants to sit there and scroll down all the way to their currency or country. I mean, I'm in South Africa right now, so every time I need to go scroll through every single country in a list, where it's just so much easier to go ahead and type it in, pull it up, and make your selection. So that's that, and that is Ajax filters for the Mastering E-commerce with Divi BodyCommerce course. And next up, we're going to start talking about our single product pages, making those look great. We're going to get into things like compare tables, the basic modules you've got on there, the advanced swatches, tons of good stuff coming up. So let's go and get into that in the next lesson. I'll see you there.